This tutorial shows how to create drop caps in Microsoft Word. Hello, my name is Erin. I'm a technical writer and editor who shares step-by-step software tutorials and writing tips for the real world on this channel and on my blog at erinwrightwriting.com. Today's tutorial shows how to create drop caps in Microsoft Word. A drop cap is a large letter at the start of a paragraph. Drop caps are traditionally used as decorative elements at the start of a document or the start of a chapter. In addition to creating drop caps, we'll also look at how to add extra customizations, such as different font colors, background colors, and drop shadows. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps will also work in Word 2019, Word 2016, Word 2013, and Word 2010. However, your interface might look slightly different in those older versions of the software. To begin, place your cursor in the paragraph that you want to format with a drop cap. Then select the Insert tab in the ribbon. Next, select the Drop Cap button in the text group. And then select an option from the drop-down menu. None will remove an existing drop cap. Dropped places the drop cap within the paragraph. In Margin places the drop cap in the margin next to the paragraph. And Drop Cap Options opens a dialog box with customization options. I'm going to choose Drop Cap Options. When the Drop Cap dialog box appears, choose Dropped or In Margin, and then choose additional options such as a different font. Note that this will change the font of the drop cap only, not the entire paragraph. Lines to drop is how large the drop cap is in relation to the text lines. The higher the line drop, the larger the drop cap. And distance from text is the space between the right edge of the drop cap and the left edge of the text. This may need to be adjusted according to your current fonts. After making your choices, select the OK button. Your drop cap should appear in your text immediately. If you want to modify your choices in the drop cap dialog box, place your cursor in the paragraph, reselect the drop cap button, and then reselect drop cap options from the drop-down menu. You can add many of the same customizations to drop caps that you can to normal text. The following steps show how to change the font color, add text effects such as a drop shadow, and add a background color. To begin, select only the drop cap. Then select the Home tab in the ribbon. To change the font color, select the Font Color menu arrow in the font group. And then choose a new color from the drop-down menu. For further options, you can select More Colors to open the Colors dialog box, where you can choose from an expanded color palette, or select the Custom tab to use RGB, HSL, or hex color codes. Additionally, you can choose Gradient to add a gradient to the current font color. Select the Text Effects and Typography button to choose options such as Outlines, Drop Shadows, and Reflections. Or choose one of the pre-made effects. Note that the effects in this drop-down menu will be affected by your font and can affect your font color, so you may need to experiment to achieve the desired results. I'm going to choose this pre-made text effects, which will replace my red font color, but add this attractive blue accent color. If you want a background color, select the Shading menu arrow in the Paragraph group, and then choose a color from the drop-down menu. Once again, you can choose more colors if you want to open the Colors dialog box for additional options. I'm going to select a light gray for my background. Your new font color, text effects, and background color should be applied immediately. As always, remember to save your file to save your changes. I have created many other videos about Microsoft Word, including how to change the default font in Microsoft Word and how to insert and modify images in Microsoft Word. Please see the complete list in the playlist titled How to Use Microsoft Word, which is linked in the description box below. The companion blog post for this video showing all the steps we just performed appears on erinwrightwriting.com, which is also linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic related to Microsoft Word, Adobe Acrobat, or Google Docs that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss future tutorials, and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.